On a Saturday night from inside the Danbury Ice Arena in downtown Danbury, Connecticut, this is Danbury Hat-Tricks Hockey, and it's live right here on the Hat-Tricks Digital Network. Hello again, Hat-Tricks fans. Doug Latuca with you on a very special Saturday night here inside the DIA. It is alumni night, the fourth annual alumni night in Danbury Hat-Tricks history, honoring the four other professional hockey teams that have called Danbury home base, going all the way back to the Danbury Trashers, then the Mad Hatters, the Whalers, the Titans, and now the Danbury Hat-Tricks here inside the Danbury Ice Arena. Tonight, the Hat-Tricks focusing in on the Danbury Titans. They are wearing Titans-themed jerseys. They are black and orange, but they have the Titan logo on the chest. Now, we've got a full night of ceremony and excitement and a packed crowd here in Danbury. Lots of Trashers jerseys being worn tonight. A lot of the festivities will occur. They will occur at the first intermission. Now I will hop off the headset at the conclusion of the first period, run down, and we will have the ceremony for you right here on the Hat-Tricks Digital Network. Now, it's the Hat-Tricks and the Black Bears tonight for the 15th time this season. Now, the Black Bears have won 9 of 14 against the Hat-Tricks, thanks in large part to 6 of the first 7 going Binghamton's way. Now, the Hat-Tricks have won 4 of the last 7 games. It was a little spurt at the end of December, beginning of January, where the Hat-Tricks got the better of Binghamton in 3 straight contests, but the Black Bears have won 3 of the last 4 between the two teams, with 2 of those games coming here in Danbury. It's time for the anthem here inside the Danbury Ice Arena. The Midnight Anthem with the National Anthem, getting us started on a Saturday night. Hat-Tricks and Black Bears for the 15th time this season out of 18. The last time these teams will meet until April. They will meet 3 of the final 4 games of the regular season for the Hat-Tricks, twice in Binghamton and 1 here in Danbury. Now, the Black Bears enter tonight's game with 91 points. It is first in the Empire and 2nd in the league. They are 7-3-0 in their last 10 games. They are 24 points ahead of the Hat-Tricks, who sit in third place. Black Bears are 29-6-6 91 points. Hat-tricks are 23, 16, and 5 with 67 points. And this game, 45 of 56. Just 12 more games on the slate for the hat-tricks for the remainder of this season. And a couple of big points up for grabs on a special alumni night here in Danbury. Now, mentioned Binghamton has been successful as of late. They've won 5 of the last 6, 14 of a possible 18 points. Hat-tricks on the other end are winners of 6 of the last 8 games, getting 17 of a possible 24 points. All right, Hat-tricks and Black Bears. First game of the weekend. 15th meeting of the season between the two sides. The puck is dropped and we are off here in Danbury. Hat-tricks starting with the top line of Johnny Ruiz, Corey Cunningham, and Daniel McKittrick with Josh LaBelle and Xavier Abdella on defense. The Hat-tricks donning the Danbury Titans themed jerseys. Yes, they are black and white. Rather, they're black and orange uniforms, but the logo on the chest is the Danbury Titans logo, as tonight is alumni night. Dakota Bond, wrist shot gobbled up by McCollum, and he holds on. No rebound. First stop for Connor McCollum, who starts for the Hat-tricks. This is 8th start in the last 11 games for the 6-1 netminder out of Pickering, Ontario, Canada. This his 10th start against Binghamton, has 3 wins in the previous 9 versus the Black Bears. Typically, it's Liam Murray who gets the nod against Binghamton. For Murray, he started 8 games, 5 of them against the Black Bears. A race for the puck. Nick DiNicola wins it. He beat Connor Smith to it. Logjam in the corner. Squirts out for Andrew Logar. Centering pass. Deflects right to Jesse Anderson. In stride, Justin Samaro. Bangs it off the board. Spinning is Logar. Low left for Samaro in his skates. Clanked out to the point. Anderson flings one wide. Scooped up far side, Smith. Brandon Stoichevsky stapling Smith to the boards. Squirts to Samaro. A minute and a half gone by. First period, no score. And the puck wobbles out to center. JT Walters on it. Hat-tricks with plenty of players in the lineup. Glove save McCollum, and he holds on. Hat-tricks going with 11 forwards and 6 defensemen. One of those forwards is Tyler Noseworthy, signed a celebrity contract today. Actually, the general manager of the junior Hat-tricks NA3 team, the assistant coach and assistant GM for the NAHL junior Hat-trick squad. Last full season was 2016-17, but played with the Hat-tricks in 21-22. He's been a part of 3 of the 5 pro teams here in Danbury. McCollum makes his 3rd save of the night. Now we will have the alumni night festivities for you throughout the game. Face off to the left of Connor McCollum. About 2 minutes gone by, first period. Shots are 3-0 in favor of the Black Bears. They have the puck of the offensive zone. Dangling through, couldn't get a shot. Rolls on, and it's steered to the far side. Tetro bangs it up the boards, and the Hat-tricks escape. McKittrick up the left wing, has Ruiz to his right. In front, Ruiz shoots, scores! Johnny Ruiz delivers again! 1-0 Hat-tricks! Came in tied for 2nd in the league in goals with 30. Make it 31 for the Hat-tricks captain. Now 9 goals in the last 7 games. His 8th goal in his 15th game against Binghamton. 18th point versus the Black Bears this season. And the Hattricks on alumni night have the fans out of their seats, and it's Johnny Ruiz. Ironically enough, Ruiz snapped his 9-game point scoring streak last week on Sunday in the 4-2 Hattricks loss to the Prowlers. During that 9-game span, he had 18 points. Here's Binghamton, shot, score! What an answer, and it's Binghamton's captain, Tyson Kirkby, who paces the Black Bears in goals, has another one here, and this game is tied. What a response from Tyson Kirkby and the Black Bears, and it's a 1-1 game. Kirkby's team-leading 26th goal, and 58th point this year. So the Hattricks 1-0 lead did not last a minute. What a quick start on a Saturday night in Binghamton, or rather in Danbury. Gavin Yates crunched in the corner, and that will be a penalty. Dustin Henning lead the hit. Coming over was Dakota Bond, and now a scrum as Yates is down holding his face. Ratcliffe helping the trainer out. And it appears that Yates is okay. He is back to his skates. Anytime a player curls up in a ball and is grabbing at his face area, you always get a little concerned because you really never know the severity of an injury like that. We do want to apologize for the static off the top. We have resolved that. We resolved it just in time, right when Johnny Ruiz scored the game-opening goal. That score coming at 2:16 of the first period. And the Hattricks 1-0 lead lasted 21 seconds. Kirkby with the goal. Now, Ruiz's goal was assisted by McKittrick, who over his last 10 games now has 13 assists for McKittrick, back up on the top line with Ruiz and Cunningham. And for McKittrick, he really started the play. It was free at center, burst up the left wing, and a backhand sauce right to the blade of Ruiz went five-hole on Nolan Egbert, who is starting tonight for the Black Bears. Now, you might remember Egbert's name from back on February 25th, the last time these teams met. He made 42 saves on 44 Hattrick shot in a 4-2 Black Bears victory. Tonight, the 29th game for Egbert, who is from Long Island. So McCollum in the Hattricks net and Egbert in for Binghamton. Now, it's a Binghamton power play, the first one of the game, and it's a 5-minute major, so this could be dangerous territory. Snapshot ramps into the netting. Now it's Dustin Henning who was assessed the 5-minute major for boarding, and that at 2:54, so just 16 seconds have ticked off the Binghamton power play, a unit that enters tonight second in the league at over 21% on the man advantage. Jesse Anderson tops the team in assists, hands off for Smith. Ruiz can't clear. Anderson, right point, shoots, airmailed it, rims around and squirts out of the zone. Hattricks with McKittrick, Falanga, Abdella, and LaBella on the ice to kill. Binghamton with Somero, Smith, Stone, Logar, and Anderson. Abdella whips it to the right point, kept in by Anderson, who angles it off the boards. Logar pressed up against the glass by Abdella. Slips free, up top Anderson, shoots, knocked down. Stone, stuff in, try off the blocker of McCollum. LaBelle corrals, clanks it off the boards. Logjam at the point, and it's out of the zone. A minute 10 off the 5-minute major assessed to Dustin Henning for boarding. Just a couple minutes into this contest, it's 1-1. Both captains have scored. Ruiz first, 21 seconds later, Kirkby with the answer. Shot whistles wide, Dakota Bond at the left point. Elevated for Yates. Low left, Thompson in the middle, Kirkby, shot stopped, and the rebound went right back to Thompson, slid off his blade. Yates to Bond. A shot from Oliveri off the blocker of McCollum. Yates wheels to the high slot, hands off Bond for Oliveri at the left circle. Looks, shoots, glove down McCollum. Yao controls, fires it down, and the Hattricks have killed off 2 minutes of the five-minute Dustin Henning major. We've played 5 minutes. First period, shots are 7-1. Black Bears, 15th meeting out of 18 between the two teams. They won't see each other until April, when they'll finish with three of the final four games against each other. Yates' shot ramps off the stick of McCollum, a scrum forward in the far corner. Two black jerseys, two white. LaBelle comes over to help as well. It's Chase Harwell, number 15. Last played on March 1st, so that was last Friday. Missed the Saturday and Sunday games, did Harwell, but points in four straight games. Actually, it was back on January 20th where Harwell picked up that six-game suspension for jumping off the bench, trying to protect his teammate Nick DiNicola. Ended up fighting and was assessed a six-game suspension, automatic for leaving the bench. So Harwell did return and just was not available for the final two games of last weekend, and is right where Billy McCreary wants him, the second center spot on this Hattricks team. Played last year in Italy, in Como. Him and Nick DiNicola teammates, and both of them from Connecticut. A minute 30 remaining on the five-minute major. Remember, this is the second best power play in the FPHL, clicking at about 22%. Hattricks on the kill, tied for fifth in the league, about 81%. They are tied for second in shorthanded goals with eight this campaign, and were a perfect 3-for-3 on Sunday in their 4-2 loss to Port Huron. 1:05 on the power play clock, centering pass, past Somero, left point Stone. Logar, spinning, looking, shoots, blocked by Abdella. Somero back on it, 7 minutes gone in the first period. Shot from the point, deflected wide. McCollum was interfered with, he's back in position. Somero at the left circle, surveys, dropping off for Logar. Back for Somero in his skates all the way out. And there goes Brendan Young, just his second pro game. Made his debut on the 1st of March. He shoots at a save by Egbert off of his chest. Second shot on goal for the Hattricks, first save. Here's Kirkby weaving in. Goes around the net. Stuffin try stop by McCollum, who's out of the play. One-timer over the net. McCollum flying around in the crease. Yates back on it. Final 15 of the power play. And Harwell swipes it out of the zone. 12:15 to go, first period. Back and forth affair. Hattricks have killed off the five-minute major to Dustin Henning. Danbury with the first goal of this game at 2:16. Binghamton answered 21 seconds later at 2:37. 1-1 game. Hattricks have killed off the first power play, and it was an extended one. Back to 5-on-5, Corey Cunningham, who's in a bit of a dry spell, three straight games without a point on the ice. Harwell's shot cranked over the net. They call an icing, I believe, on the play. Either way, we're at the media timeout. 1-1, frenetic pace on a Saturday night here in Danbury. We'll be back on the Hattricks Digital Network.
Stop by TK's American Cafe on White Street in Danbury and try one of their 76 amazing wing flavors. Visit TK'sAmericanCafe.com for more information.
Danbury Parking Authority. Park in the Patriot Garage across the street from the Danbury Ice Arena. It's safe, secure, and legal. Make sure the only ticket you get is to the game.
Danbury Chiropractic and Wellness. Dr. Jared DiLorenzo is a proud member of the Danbury Hattricks medical team. Stop by and see them on North Street in downtown Danbury. Feeling good is an option, and they can get you there.
BuzzAid Appliance Scratch and Dent Outlet is the local leader for appliances and household wares. Do you like to eat? They have a refrigerator. Do you want clean clothes? They have a washer. They got it all. It's BuzzAid Appliance. Coca-Cola is the official beverage of the Danbury Hat-Tricks. Sweet, fizzy goodness. As refreshing as you remember.
Doug Latuca back with you inside the Danbury Ice Arena. 1-1 the score. Hat-Tricks and Black Bears. 11:39 to play, first period. Shots are 7-2 Binghamton. And at the first media timeout of the game, Dom Alessandro, one of the four Danbury Hockey Ring of Honor inductees tonight, was recognized. There will be a ceremony during the first intermission. I'll take the headset off, hop downstairs, and lead those festivities. You can catch it all right here on the Hat-Tricks Digital Network. Dom designed four of the five pro hockey team logos here in Danbury. The Trashers, Whalers, Titans, and the Hat-Tricks, and has helped out with other graphics, clothing design, jersey design, actually designed the jerseys the Hat-Tricks are wearing tonight with the Titans emblem on the front. Here's Cunningham shooting in a left pad, saved by Egbert. Whistle blows, penalty on the Black Bears. It's a hook on Jesse Anderson. And after Binghamton unsuccessful on a 5-minute power play following the Dustin Henning boarding, that at around 2:30 into this contest. Now Jesse Anderson sits, and the Hat-Tricks power play, which is scorching hot, heads right back to work. Danbury with power play goals in 8 of the last 9 games. And the top unit on with LaBelle leading. His shot whistles wide of the far post. Johnny Ruiz leads the team in power play goals with 8. The Hat-Tricks are still 9th in the league on the power play, but they have been climbing all season. It's been well documented, up to about 17%. And the Hat-Tricks, over their last 78 tries, at 21%. And they have 9 power play goals and 77 tries versus Binghamton. A large sample size in this, the 15th game against the Black Bears. And now 37 seconds off the Hat-Tricks power play.
We're going to get our next inductee on the video board. This guy's a former Danbury Titan.
Nolan Egbert.
And a Danbury Hat-Trick, Phil Garner, he's in the building tonight.
Has made 3 saves on 4 Hat-Trick shots so far tonight. Mentioned his 42 saves on 44 tries back on February 25th, last time these two met in a Binghamton 4-2 win. It was actually tied with about 5 minutes to go. And then it was Peter Izzo in his first pro game. First game with the Black Bears. Beat Murray over the left shoulder. Made it 3-2. Binghamton added the empty netter. And that was all she wrote. 40 seconds on the Hat-Tricks power play. Puck rolling down on McCollum. He springs it out to center. Dina Cola's stick lifted. And the Black Bears snap it down the ice. Just 30 ticks remaining on the Hat-Tricks opening power play. Jacob Ratcliffe with the fishbowl. Had quite the weekend against the Prowlers. Had the shootout winner on Friday night in the Hat-Tricks 6-5 victory over Port Huron. And for Ratcliffe, it's 5 points in the last 3 games. Had missed 10 games with an upper body injury. Returned last weekend and made his presence felt immediately. Power play is over. Both teams are 0-1. On the man advantage. 1-1 the score, approaching 9 minutes to go in the opening period. Doug Latuca with you on a Saturday night from Danbury. Nick DiNicola backtracking in his own zone. Back-to-back games with an assist for DiNicola, who this season is 3rd on the team at assists with 24. Pamela Lane lifts it in. Walters retrieves. Closed off by Falanga. Slipped up the boards. Pamela Lane in pursuit. It's chipped ahead. Here comes Connor Smith up the right wing. Smith drags. Pass down low. They score. Jesse Anderson on the doorstep. Taps it home. And Binghamton takes a 2-1 lead with 8:30 remaining in the opening period. Anderson's eighth goal of the season. And it pushes the Black Bears in front, 2-1. Not much McCollum could do there. It was a 2-on-1 to begin with. Then the defenseman went gliding past McCollum, left the passing lane wide open, and a tap-in for Anderson. And he almost shot it right into the right pad of McCollum, but snuck it through. Here's Ruiz off the opening draw. Pass across, the shot stopped by Egbert. Might have been fanned on. That is Tyler Noseworthy, who is playing in his first game this season with the hat tricks, a celebrity contract for the 32-year-old Noseworthy. Last played in 2021-22 with the hat tricks, but has been on three separate pro teams in Danbury and just missed a tap-in goal of his own. Timeout here in Danbury. Binghamton leading 2-1. We'll step aside, come right back.
Coltec, the founder of Plastic Chamber Technology, is headquartered locally in Brookfield. Coltec is family-owned and operated with experience in the drainage industry dating back to the 1950s. When you're talking drainage and stormwater, Coltec is the world leader. Contact them today at coltec.com.
Fairfield County Bank is the official bank of the Danbury Hat Tricks. It's where the Hat Tricks bank and the tellers wear the Danbury Hat Tricks top hat. Fairfield County Bank is your hometown bank and a proud supporter of your hometown team.
For a comfortable stay with great amenities, the only choice is the La Quinta by Wyndham in Danbury. Ask for the Hat Tricks friends and family rate. You can't beat it. La Quinta.
Texas Roadhouse, located on Newtown Road in Danbury, opened its doors locally in 2017 and is known for hand-cut steaks, cactus blossom, fall off the...
We welcome you back to the Danbury Ice Arena. Black Bears 2, Hat Tricks 1, looking for an answer. Ruiz, one-timer. Stopped by Egbert, lost his stick. Hat Tricks keep it alive. Noseworthy, wrist shot, blocked. Another opportunity in the center, and it was picked off by the Black Bears. They escaped the other way. Anderson had it hop over his stick. McKittrick on the left side has the assist on the Hat Tricks' lone goal tonight. Storms up the left wing, flutters one on, and it's gloved by Egbert. The whistle upcoming to his right. He has made six saves on seven shots. Now it's just announced that Johnny Ruiz has reached 150 professional goals. You have to account for his time outside of Danbury. He did play a bit in Elmira during the COVID year, and Ruiz has been around the block and one of the more popular players in Danbury hockey history. Definitely Danbury Hat Tricks history, but overall he almost leads in every offensive category. And his team-high 31st goal, also good enough for second in the FPHL. And now 150 in his pro career, and probably very close to 150 in his Hat Tricks career as well. Puck is dumped in, took an awkward carom off the corner boards. That's Kyle Steffen. Hasn't played pro hockey in 4 years. Wrist shot off the stick of McCollum. 2-on-1 for the Hat Tricks. Falanga flips it across DiNicola. Falanga streaking pass for him. He scored! Michael Falanga ties the game. Snaps an 18-game goalless drought. It's 2-2. He started to play in the neutral zone. Backhand sauce for DiNicola, who returned the favor on the give and go. Falanga did not get all of it, just enough to tap it over the outstretched glove of Egbert, and we are tied at 2. Shots are even at 8. The score 2-2. What a first period on alumni night here in Danbury. Alumni old and new filling the stands, and they like what they see. Hattrick started the scoring about 3 minutes in. Binghamton answered 21 seconds later. They grabbed a 2-1 lead at 11:27 of the period. And Danbury's answer at 13:10. Falanga has tied the game. Falanga's third goal of the season. Mentioned he hadn't scored a goal since December 1st against Motor City. His second goal in eight games versus Binghamton. So two goals for Falanga out of his three this season have come against the Black Bears. Under six to go, opening period, tie game. Gavin Yates swoops in, left side, fakes the shot, wrap around, hit the outside of the net. Josh LaBelle spinning behind the cage, eludes the stick check of Kirkby, and hands off for Xavier Abdella. He darts up the near side, self-pass off the boards. Ruiz picks it off at center, walks the line, brought it in offside. And a whistle with 5:30 on the clock, opening period, 2-2 the score. Now the Hattricks honored Phil Bronner at the last timeout. It was Dom Alessandro at the under 15, Phil Bronner at the under 10. Played for the Titans and the Hattricks did Phil Bronner. A big-bodied offensive weapon, fighter, and was all over the place during his time in Danbury. Terrific video. We'll have all those videos for you at the first intermission once I hop back upstairs after emceeing the Alumni Night festivities. Chase Harwell buzzing around the ice, throwing his body around. Nick DiNicola gallops through center, shovels it in. Ratcliffe in a foot race with Anderson. Jesse Anderson with one of the two Binghamton goals tonight. Now his twin brother, Liam Anderson, not in the lineup tonight. And he has been elevated, not with the Black Bears. Dustin Henning is back, served his five-minute boarding. That was back at 2:16. Rather, 2:54 of this period. Hattricks killed it off. Shots are 11-9. Black Bears were level at two. Thompson, elevated pass through everyone. McCullum out of the cage. Bangs it off the boards. Kept in at the line by Colin Fitzgerald. First game this season with the Black Bears. His third season overall with Binghamton was with the Huntsville Havoc in the SPHL. Returning for Binghamton at just the right time because Jake Schultz, one of their top D-men, is no longer with the squad. Kyle Steffen turned around in the corner. Ruiz prying for it. They battle two aside. Steffen picks it free. McKittrick got his blade on it. It spits out for Smith. He dangled to the line, turn, shoots, deflected wide by Logar. 3.5, the reading on the clock. First period, 2-2 the score. Henning reared back, fakes it, flips it to the right point. Long range shot blocked down. Somero, the righty on his backhand, sent it back to the point. Binghamton making a change. Dakota Bond, the player that stepped on, retrieved to the neutral zone and slingshots it in. McCullum keeps it moving around the boards. Skate to stick, Somero, left point, Bond, shoots, save, rebound bouncing around. Stone connects at the right point. Purposefully wide off the end boards. Sam Tetro, headband for McKittrick, Harwell for Cunningham. Around the check of Stone. Paddled aside by Egbert, and the Black Bears reset in the zone. The outlet for Smith off of his stick. Tetro to Pamelayan through Harwell, who has it back, standing on top of the blue line. Logar looking for Yates, picked off. Ratcliffe eludes a check, sauced it in, and Binghamton with Gavin Yates, enter the offensive zone. Right side, Yates, backhand pass goes on goal. And McCullum halts play. Final timeout in the opening period. 2-2 the score. Final 2:20 when we come back on the Hattrix Digital Network.
Diversified Printing Solutions in Danbury is the Hattrix official printing partner. You want it printed? Call Tina and let them get it inked up for you. They could do it all. Locally owned and printed on paper from Connecticut trees.
Dr. Matt Hartsburg is an official member of the Danbury Hattrix medical team. Hartsburg Chiropractic is cutting-edge chiropractic care right here in your backyard. Check out Hartsburg Chiropractic and get on the road to a pain-free hockey season. Blue Light Electric is a proud sponsor of the Danbury Hattrix. Blue Light Electric happily provides service to all parts of Connecticut, performing high-quality electrical work for residential and commercial properties. Blue Light Electric is always accepting new customers.
Litchfield Distillery. It's the spirit of hard work. The Batchers of Litchfield Distillery, in honor of the early farmers of Northwest Connecticut, present to you the locally made Litchfield Distillery bourbon, vodka, and gin. Grab a beverage at the Rabbit Hole and hoist the barrel with the Hattrix.
Black Bears 2, Hattrix 2, 2:19 remaining opening period on a Saturday night from inside the Danbury Ice Arena. Doug Latuca with you. Shots are 12-9 Binghamton. Hattrix possessed a 1-0 lead, 2:16 into this game. Binghamton answered 21 seconds later, then grabbed the go-ahead goal at 11:27. Hattrix with the equalizer at 13:10, and that is where we stand, 2-2 with under 2:20 to go in this period. Yates off the faceoff, slipped it in front, blocked by a kneeling LaBelle. Jacob Ratcliffe on the right side, bangs it off the boards. DiNicola racing after it, was hauled down, and a penalty comes from it. Now, Binghamton arguing that DiNicola fell on his own, but the Hattrix 5-10 forward from Walcott, Connecticut, took a spill. Jesse Anderson to the penalty box, and the Hattrix, who are 0-for-1 on the power play tonight, get their second opportunity. Mentioned that the Hattrix have power play goals in 8 of their last 9 games, went 1-for-6 on Sunday in that 4-2 loss to Port Huron. Binghamton clears off the faceoff with under 2 to go in the first period. At all 3 breaks in the period, the Hattrix honoring the Ring of Honor inductees. First it was Dom Alessandro, then Phil Bronner, and most recently Brad Wingfield, who is arguably the most popular Danbury professional hockey player of all time. Played with the Trashers, standing ovation when his video played up on the board. He is here in attendance tonight. Point shot, blocked down, Harwell prying for it, chipped up the boards. And it's wheeled back below the goal line. Clear attempt. McKittrick overskated, but glues it to the near corner. Cunningham's pass intercepted and flung down the ice. The Hattrix goals scored by Johnny Ruiz at 2:16 and Michael Falanga at 13:10. For Ruiz, his 150th goal in the FPHL. Now second in the league in goals with 31. Leads the Hattrix in mostly every offensive category and is top 2 or 3 in every offensive category. Final 30 seconds of the Hattrix power play. Binghamton fired it out of play. Hattrix wanting a delay of game. I do not believe they will get it. Now this is the 15th meeting out of 18 between the two teams. They'll see each other 3 more times, all coming in April, twice in Binghamton, 1 here in Danbury. The Hattrix have beaten Binghamton 5 times this season. In 4 of them, the Hattrix have netted 4 or more goals. In every other game, besides the one win in the season series opener all the way back in October where the Hattrix scored 3 goals. The Hattrix have yet to win a game against Binghamton when they have scored fewer than 4 goals. Danbury already with 2 tonight. Black Bears with 2 as well. That'll do it for the Hattricks power play. Final 5 seconds of the period. Weber content to let the time roll out. And that is it for the opening period. 2-2 the score. Hattricks and Black Bears. 15th of 18 meetings in the first game of two for the Hattricks this weekend. Back at it tomorrow against Elmira. The goal scorers, Ruiz at 216, Kirkby at 237, and Anderson at 1127. And the Hattricks tying the game at 13-10. Falanga with the goal. Hattricks 0-2 on the power play. Binghamton 0-1. They had a 5-minute opportunity and did not score. I'm going to take the headset off, run downstairs. We're going to run the Ring of Honor and Hall of Fame Alumni Night festivities here at the DIA. We'll talk again once it's over, but just stay with us. We'll have it all for you right here on the Hattricks Digital Network.
All alumni, please come down to the penalty box. Please come down to the penalty box. All right, fans, we are getting ready to start here. We're going to start. All right. We've got Jolene Dodd from the Danbury Whalers and Titans game day staff. Bob Brock from the Trashers, Whalers and Titans video crew. The voice of the Danbury Trashers, Phil. Game operations, Kenny Waterhouse from the Whalers and Trashers is here. From the Danbury Trashers bus crew, Johnny Mara. Captain America, he's been with every team, right from the Danbury Police Force, Sergeant John. Fans, we got Brendan Keystone, the general manager of the Danbury Mad Hatters, and he's coming out there with his nicely dressed Brendan Keystone Jr. The Keystones are here tonight. He only played 6 games in this building as part of the home team, but they were memorable. He never lost any one of them. He was 6-0. Number 22, Matt Pontarari is here. From the Danbury Mad Hatters, 7 games, 54 penalty minutes, Jason Michelson is here. Oh, part of the Danbury Whalers defense crew, Danbury Hattricks coaching staff. Adam Blanchett is in the building. He played 50 games in this building for the home team. The Whalers, the Titans. He scored 4 goals. One was in the Cup Finals. He also had 321 penalty minutes. He's a Cup champion. The big pizza, Anthony Pizzano. He's got one game played for the Danbury Hattricks, but he's got a 5-minute fighting major. Zach Lesher is here. One of those popular players for the Danbury Whalers of all time, Super Joe, Joe Dabkowski is here. Joe played 37 games, 15 goals as a Whaler. All right, from the front office, from the Danbury Whalers, from the Danbury Titans, she's the assistant general manager, Trisha Coe is in the building tonight. He was a 4-year member of the Danbury Whalers. He's now Dr. Jared Balog. He's here tonight. He's a member of the Danbury Hattricks Championship squad. 48 games, 19 goals, 14 playoff games, 7 goals in the playoffs, and 1 cup. Fans, this one is real special. Peter Ventry, a 4-year member of the Whalers, passed away this offseason. Peter played 42 games, 13 in the playoffs. He was a Cup champion. His cousin, Leanna Shrepard, is here to represent him. Out of there for Leanna. He's a 3-year hat trick, 96 games, 34 goals, 15 playoff games, and 1 cup championship, Gordy Bunnell. He's got 85 games as a home player here for the hat tricks. 85 games and 56 goals. That's a pretty good number. Number 27, Corey Anderson. He's the president of the 2013 Danbury Whaler Championship squad. One of the building blocks of hockey in Danbury. Alan Friedman is here, team president. Fans, he is the chairman of the Danbury Whalers. My father, Lawrence Sorcher. Okay, here we go. He's played in this building and won a championship as a competitor. But we got him here on our side and he brought us a championship. Head coach, general manager,
to the title of the night where we honor our Ring of Honor inductees tonight. We'll pass it over to my friend Greg. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the 2024 Danbury Ring of Honor inductees. One of the keys in the history of Danbury hockey, this inductee solidified his contribution to Danbury hockey by designing four of the five teams to call Danbury home. Please welcome Don Alessandro. Our next inductee has 88 games and 52 goals between the Danbury Lions and Hattricks, a crucial part of the leadership group.
and I have made it back up to the broadcast booth. What a spectacle. The festivities in between the first and second period in a 2-2 hockey game. A very special alumni night. Herm Sorcher leading the charge, took the mic, and introduced every single one of the alumni in attendance tonight, headlined by the Ring of Honor inductees. We will play their video shortly. It is Brad Wingfield who is taking a picture in the far right corner off to your screen, and AJ Galanti, who was the general manager of the Danbury Trashers, the youngest GM in professional hockey history, led the Trashers for 2 years. They were Eastern Division champs in the UHL, the United Hockey League, in 2004. Rather, in 2005 and 6. They played from 04 to 06. So AJ and his dad, Jim, here tonight. Two keystones in Danbury professional hockey history. Brad Wingfield, one of, as I mentioned during the action, one of, if not the most popular players in Danbury hockey history. Now, he was honored tonight, and a couple others as well, and they all submitted videos that were played throughout the first period. Now, we'll start with Jason McCrimmon, who is a big dude, played with the Danbury Whalers, one of Patrick's president, Herm Sorcher's, favorite players. If you watched our preview video we posted midweek, a little sit down with myself, Billy McCreary, and Herm Sorcher, you saw some of the footage. McCrimmon was someone not to be messed with, and when you did, he made you pay. One of the most beloved players in Whalers history, and he was not able to make it to Danbury tonight, still coaching some junior hockey that he has taken up. He was the winner of the Willie O'Ree Award for work in the community handed out by the NHL. Of course, Willie O'Ree, the legendary hockey player, actually presented Jason with the award, and here's what he had to say. We apologize for the grainy footage.
So just very, very excited for this honor. Thank you for the opportunity. I appreciate my time in Danbury. Section 102, you know, Herm, all the boys, just being able to be a part of that organization. And now to receive this honor, I'm beyond excited. And like I said, just grateful, you know, being the game of hockey and having my journey go through Danbury, Connecticut, and be a part of this great organization. I appreciate you, Herm. I appreciate the guys. I appreciate, like I said, again, Section 102, and just great honor to be part of the Ring of Honor. Greatly appreciate it. Thank you.
So congratulations to Jason McCrimmon, one of the four inductees tonight into the Danbury Hockey Ring of Honor. We'll show you the other videos right now. Dom Alessandro was the first inductee honored at the under 15 break. The designer of four logos in Danbury professional hockey history, the Trashers, Whalers, Titans, and Hattricks. Here is what Dom had to say.
Hello to my Danbury hockey family. I love what we have created here over the past 20 years. It really feels like family. It's been one of the greatest joys of my career as a graphic designer to combine my passion for design and my love of hockey to create the team logos, starting with the Trashers, then the Whalers, the Titans, and our current Hattricks. Thank you for recognizing the importance of design and its power to unite our community. It's been amazing to see you, the fans, enjoying my logos, wearing jerseys, merchandise, and even some who have gotten tattoos. Just incredible. I want to thank Herm and the Hattricks organization for recognizing my efforts. It is a great honor to have my name hang in the arena next to the true legends of Danbury hockey. Thank you so much, and go Hattricks!
What an incredible guy, Dom Alessandro. I've worked closely with him, especially in the offseason leading up to the start of this season. Helps out with the graphics, designed the jerseys that the Hattricks are wearing tonight, and some of the merchandise that maybe you have worn this season. So Dom, the second that we've shown tonight out of the four. Now Phil Bronner is next, member of the Hattricks and the Titans, another big-bodied forward, a power forward, some would say, and he's got a pretty interesting video, and let's take a look at it.
Danbury, as you can see, I'm really enjoying retirement away from the game, becoming a modern-day Happy Gilmore. Really miss all the hits.
Far side corner with 3 minutes left to play in the first period.
The fights.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, and here goes Bronner. Bronner swing.
Scoring. Yeah! Yeah! The wins. Just want to say thank you to the Danbury Hattricks organization, Billy Herm, the Diamonds, back to the Titans, Bruce Bennett, the Titan family, Espo for drafting me, all my teammates, of course, my parents, family, my wife, supporting me, allowing me to play professional hockey as long as I did. Really appreciate being recognized tonight. It's a privilege and an honor to play in front of a hockey city like Danbury, and cheers to everybody. Go Hattricks.
Oh, wouldn't it be great to be out on the golf course right now? 75 and sunny, chugging a beer and driving. Sounds pretty good. Pretty good to me. And Phil Bronner, of course, enjoying himself. Appreciate him for recording that video. Another legend here in Danbury hockey history. And the final and maybe most popular out of the group in terms of if you go all the way back to the Trashers days, this is Brad Wingfield, who got a lot of love on social media prior. He had his own paparazzi during the first intermission ceremony, camera following him around, and I'm sure on the Danbury Trashers social media accounts, he'll be all over it. But here's what he had to say for this special night.
What's up, Danbury? Is it ever good to be back? It's Brad Wingfield here. Super excited to be here with you guys tonight. Just such a big honor to be inducted, and want to say thank you first and foremost to the Danbury Hattricks for making it happen. I want to say thank you to Jimmy and AJ Galante all those years back for having me and the Trashers. It was just the most awesome experience. But you guys, Danbury, you guys are the best fans in all of hockey, and it was an honor for me to play in front of you guys. It's going to be an awesome night. Looking forward to it.
Brad Winger Wingfield, the fourth and final inductee into the Ring of Honor. What a night it has been. Four goals in the opening period, two apiece. Hattrick started the scoring and ended the scoring in the period. Ruiz and Falanga starting and then bookending. Two Binghamton goals sandwiched in between Kirkby and Anderson. Now the Hattricks had the 1-0 lead. 21 seconds later, Kirkby answers Ruiz. The captains both scoring for their respective sides. Then Anderson at 11:27 made it 2-1 Binghamton. And then Falanga, about a minute and a half apart from the Anderson goal, scored his third of the season, second against Binghamton this season. And for Ruiz, 150 FPHL goals, second in the league this year in goals with 31 as he continues to lead the charge for this Hattricks team. He now has points in 10 of his last 11 games. 13 goals during that span, 19 points. 9 goals in the last 7 games for the Hattricks captain, and 18 points in this his 15th game against Binghamton. Now we'll reiterate one more stat for you, which is pretty crucial. The Hattricks have 5 wins versus Binghamton this season. 4 of them, the Hattricks have scored 4-plus goals. The only one where they did not reach that total was October, all the way back on the 20th, a 3-2 shootout victory. It's the third game of the season for the Hattricks, first in this long season series. This is the 15th meeting, but that was the first one. The Hattricks scored three goals and won the game 3-2 in a shootout. And in every game that the Hattricks have not reached four or more goals, they have lost to Binghamton this season. Through the first 14 games, they have four wins where they've eclipsed that number, gotten to four or more, and the one game where they did not. But they have not won a game against Binghamton where they have not scored four-plus goals this season. We're about 5 minutes away from the second period. 2-2 the score. Doug Latuca with you. We will step aside and come back for period number two. Stay with us. Welcome you back inside the Danbury Ice Arena. Period two, Hattricks and Black Bears, first game of the weekend for the Hattricks on a Saturday night. They return to action tomorrow afternoon, 3 o'clock puck drop against the Elmira River Sharks. Hello again, Hattricks fans. Doug Latuca with you. 20 minutes in the books, 2-2 the score. Hattricks jumped out to a 1-0 lead. Johnny Ruiz's 150th goal in the FPHL at 2:16. Then Binghamton's captain at 2:37, Tyson Kirkby, evened the score. Black Bear stepped in front 2-1 on Jesse Anderson's score at 11:27. And the Hattricks about a minute and a half later at 13:10. Michael Falanga tied up the game. Teams flip sides, Hattricks moving right to left, middle frame, and we are off and running in period two. Game 15 out of 18 between the two teams this season. Hattricks have won 5 of the first 14 between the two sides. And in all of those games, the Hattricks have scored 4-plus goals. Well, Danbury is halfway there, and so is Binghamton. Both of these teams red hot as of late. Johnny Ruiz starts with Corey Cunningham and Daniel McKittrick, top line for the Hattricks. Cunningham fending off the check of Bond, slips it inside for McKittrick. They crisscross in the skates of Daniel Stone. They battle to a side of the far boards. Gavin Yates comes over, pried it free. Ruiz shoved him. It's kicked away. Here's Dom Oliveri. Breakaway up the left side, one-on-one with McCollum. Shoots off the mask of McCollum. He goes down on his stomach. Appears to be okay. Back to his skates at least. They call it offsides. Gavin Yates dragged it out, brought it back in. And now you got a check on Connor McCollum. Might have got his bell rung. Puck hit him in the mask. Binghamton winners of 5 of the last 6, grabbing 14 of a possible 18 points. Hattricks with victories in 6 of the last 8 games, 17 of a possible 24 points. Now Binghamton leads this season series pretty drastically, and it's thanks in large part to winning 6 of the first 7 games against the Hattricks in this season series. The only one they dropped was the first one back on October 20th, the 3-2 shootout win here in Danbury. Then the Hattricks won 3 in a row at the end of December, beginning of January against Binghamton, but the Black Bears have gotten the better of the Hattricks over the last 7. They have won 3 of the last 4 against the Hattricks, but Danbury has won 4 of the last 7. But what have you done lately? And for Binghamton, they are the top team of the Empire with 91 points. Yowris shot floats high off the backboards. Jesse Anderson settles, bangs it off the end boards. The race for it in the near corner. Samaro twisting. Ratcliffe and Harwell team up in front. Harwell couldn't uncork it, and it spits out to center. Connor Woolley to Tetro, steps over the red line and wrists it in. Fresh off the bench, it's Brandon Stoichevsky. Has points in 3 straight games. The rookie center iceman pass for Falanga. Shot it off a stick and over the net. He scored the Hattrick second goal, breaking a dry spell for number 10 in black. Hadn't scored in 18 games coming in to tonight. Hattrick's wearing the Danbury Titan themed jerseys tonight. It is alumni night at the DIA. Ceremony in between the first and second period. 4 Ring of Honor inductees enshrined into the Danbury Hockey Ring of Honor just a couple moments ago. Great ceremony. We appreciate all the alumni for coming out and being with us. Stoichevsky in the far corner, surveys, up top Falanga, shoots, deflected, and a rebound over the stick of Stoichevsky. Puck is rainbowed through center, settled by Pamelaan, who twists in his own zone, pressured by Andrew Uturo, who scored the last time these teams met on February 25th, a 4-2 Binghamton win. It was actually Peter Izzo in his pro debut with Binghamton, who scored the go-ahead and game-winning goal. Made it 3-2 very late in that contest. They added an empty netter to take it 4-2. We've played 3 minutes, second period. Shots are even at 16. So is the score at 2. Ruiz kicks it to himself, steams up the right side, flips it off the boards. Cunningham scoops up the loose change, trailing LaBelle. Wine shoots, saved by Egbert. And the rebound finds the stick of Cunningham. Low left, Ruiz. Toe drag, Ruiz in front, looking for McKittrick on the right doorstep. Squirts out to Abdella. High to low, off the stick of Kirkby. Pops to the far boards, McKittrick. Wins the battle in the corner. Ruiz slid it inside for Cunningham, swept off his stick, and Daniel Stone charges after it. And Sky pops it through center. As we're approaching about 4 minutes off the clock, second period. Still 2-2. Jacob Ratcliffe dancing at the red line. Connects with DiNicola inside Harwell. On the backhand, spins in front, they score! A lucky bounce! Chase Harwell with the goal, and the hat-tricks have a one-goal lead. Harwell stays hot. 5 straight games with a point. 4 goals during that span. His 5th goal versus Binghamton. And it gives the hat-tricks a 1-goal advantage. Hat-tricks get a lucky bounce early here in the second period. And they regain a 1-goal lead, which they possessed in the early stages of the first period. A turnover, here's Brendan Young, flipped it wide. Looking for his first pro point in his second game. Yao uncorked, stopped by Egbert. Rebound, a juicy one. Yao's follow-up. Egbert doesn't know where it is. It's swiped to the far corner and lofted through center. Hat-tricks applying pressure. They've got a 1-goal lead. Jared Yao points in 3 straight. Sachet's out of the zone. Tape-to-tape with Young. Speeds up the left side. In the middle, Stoichevsky off of his blade. The big center Iceman regathers, sauces up top. Yao skate to stick, dances around one, walks the wall, looking for a lane in the middle. Knocked down, pass for Stoichevsky, stuffed by Egbert. Hat-tricks buzzing in the O-zone, about 5 minutes gone, second period. Danbury in front by 1. Stoichevsky along the near side, slips it for Young, lifts the stick of Walters. He lost his twig. Young inside McKittrick, uncorks one over the net and off the end glass. Hamilton sockers it off the boards. It's poked free by Smith. He needs a change. Hat-tricks turn it quickly. McKittrick flips it in. Ruiz chases. Jesse Anderson got there first. Rimmed it around. Tetro pinching. And it wobbles out to center where Hamilton dishes it right back in. 5.5 off the clock, second period. Hat-tricks with a 3-2 lead on Chase Harwell's 9th goal of the season. He has 6 points in his last 5 games, points in all 5 of those contests. Ratcliffe wrists one off the blocker of Egbert and out of play. Harwell with the go-ahead goal. Assisted by Nick DiNicola and Jacob Ratcliffe to put the hat-tricks in the lead. We'll step aside, 3-2 Danbury on the Hat-Tricks Digital Network.
Stony Hill Dental Care has served as the leader and preferred provider of dental care in Bethel, Connecticut. Go see Dr. K. He'll make you look like $1 million and feel like it too. The official team dentist of the Danbury Hat-Tricks.
Vision Designs is the official merchandiser of the Danbury Hat-Tricks. Vision Designs is a full-service screen printing, embroidery, signage, and promotional company locally owned and operated in Brookfield. Vision Designs is the hometown company with the national power. Check them out at visiondesignct.com.
Decker Tool Rental is the official full-service equipment rental shop of the Danbury Hat-Tricks, providing a complete line of quality equipment to all types of contractors, tradesmen, and do-it-yourselfers. Visit them today at 84 Federal Road in Danbury or on the web at deckertoolrental.com.
Kafala Coffee. Real coffee, good coffee, no, great coffee. Plus hot chocolate right on the concourse level at the Danbury Ice Arena. Kafala Coffee. Stay warm this winter.
Doug Latuca back with you inside the Danbury Ice Arena, and the Hattricks with a one-goal advantage thanks to Chase Harwell at his ninth goal of the season. Now has points in five straight games. Has another opportunity, and he's got his second of the night! Top shelf magic, Chase Harwell, and it's 4-2 Hattricks. Well, that was quick. Almost right off the faceoff. Harwell with his 10th goal of the season, and the Hattricks with their largest lead of the night. Egbert beat over the left shoulder. And Harwell, who hadn't played the last two games last weekend, right back in the lineup tonight. And cashing in, gave the Hattricks a lead and has ballooned it to 2. So you have to expect an answer from Binghamton, the top team of the Empire Division with 91 points. They've lost in regulation just 6 times and have topped the Hattricks in 3 of the last 4 games. But right now, Danbury with the momentum. The crowd practically just getting resettled back in after waiting around during the alumni Ring of Honor ceremony in between the first and second period. But Harwell with back-to-back goals has the Hattricks in front by 2. Ratcliffe with another assist. He assisted on Ratcliffe's first goal of the game. So another couple of helpers for Jacob Ratcliffe, who is on an absolute tear as of late. Has 25 assists. Here's Yates on a breakaway. He scored! Fake to the backhand, tucked it in on the forehand. And Binghamton has cut the deficit to 1. So Yates, right when the Hattricks had all the life, Yates picks up his 16th goal of the season. And once again, we've got a one-goal game. Bit of a clock malfunction. More time ran off after the goal was scored. But it is just back and forth action between these two teams. 7 goals scored already, and we've played about 27 minutes. Now, the clock was the issue, so they are correcting that at the moment. So let's try and recap what has gone on here in the second period. So Harwell with goals at 3:56 and 5:54, so a minute and 58 seconds apart. My math is correct. It's incorrect. Oh no, it is correct. I believe so. A minute 58 apart. Sounds about right. Harwell with 2 goals. First one assisted by Nick DiNicola and Jacob Ratcliffe. So for DiNicola, it's 3 straight goals, 3 straight games with an assist. He actually has his 2nd of the night, and we mentioned Ratcliffe with 2 assists, had the helper on the 2nd Harwell goal. So that 2nd line all over the score sheet here in period number 2. But Gavin Yates with the most recent tally has the crowd a bit muffled after celebrating 2 quickies from Harwell. You know Binghamton's not going to go away. They were down 3-1 in the first period last night against Elmira and won it 5-3 coming all the way back. Ruiz shoots from the right wing. Stopped by Egbert, then gets tossed in the process. Back to his skates. He's on it in the far corner. Slips it inside for McKittrick, stolen away by Somero. Weber led the break. Nearly lost it to Ruiz, who pesters him from behind. McKittrick takes it away in the corner. Pitchforks it below the goal line. And coming away with it is Colin Fitzgerald, his first game with Binghamton this season, third season overall for the defenseman. He's with Huntsville for about 25 games this year. Unloads a wrist shot, went wide, rebound Smith. Flipped it wide of the net. Harwell already has two goals, drops off for DiNicola, takes a hit. Ratcliffe up the left wing, curls, gets stapled to the boards by Utoro. Thompson chips and chases. McCollum out of the net, intercepted by Utoro. Puck pops into the glove of McCollum. And he holds on after the whistle, pushing and shoving as we expected off the top. It's the 15th matchup of 18 this year between the two teams. Both these teams not the biggest fans of each other, and some scrums behind the net. You know, this period could get a little chippy. We've seen the offense in full display, 7 total goals already. We're not even midway through the contest. Now, that is Nick DiNicola being ushered to the penalty box. And Josh Fletcher for Binghamton. You'd have to assume that it will be even. 2 minutes for roughing to both of them, and we can play on here. First game of two for the Hattricks this weekend. Tomorrow it's a 3 o'clock puck drop. Skate with the Hattricks after the game. Danbury is 0 for 2 in Sunday afternoon games here in Danbury. Their only other Sunday games on the road, one in Binghamton, a victory. That was actually on New Year's Eve, 4-3 in a shootout. And then a win a couple weekends ago in Watertown, 5-1 over the Wolves. Now penalties are coming in. All I see are two players, one in each box. It's the same two we mentioned, Fletcher for Binghamton, DiNicola for Danbury. It's already past 8:30. Here on the East Coast, an extended intermission due to the Alumni Night festivities. And the only question is, will they play 4-on-4 or 5-on-5? And there is your answer. Four black jerseys, four white. Ruiz, McKittrick, Abdella, and LaBelle for Danbury. Kirkby with Walters, Jesse Anderson, and Yates. So used to saying Jesse Anderson because his twin brother Liam is typically in the lineup. But not tonight, so Anderson will do. Right off the faceoff, McKittrick shoots, blocked, followed up by Abdella over his stick. LaBelle flings one wide. Egbert caught off guard. Ruiz's centering pass through LaBelle. Anderson chugging after it, sticked away by Abdella. Walters drags it out of the zone, and Yates, who has the most recent goal in the game, zigzags through center. Gains the line, goes wide on LaBelle. Under 11 to go here in the second period. One goal, Hattricks advantage. Abdella shielding the puck from Anderson. One hands it for LaBelle. 50 seconds off the 4-on-4. Hattricks making partial changes. Outlet for Harwell, picked off by Stone. Daniel Stone steps over the red, over the blue, chips, charges, stopped by LaBelle, turned it over to Oliveri. Dangles around one, Smith on the right side, doorstep feed for Stone, tipped out of play at the last moment by Ratcliffe, and a faceoff upcoming in a Hattrick zone. Still 46 ticks on this 4-on-4. The penalties, both roughing on Fletcher and DiNicola. Face off to the right of McCollum. Not quite yet. It's Oliveri And Harwell. Chase wins it for Danbury. Ratcliffe reverses for Tetro. Harwell stapled along the boards. Gave it away. Stone across for Bond at the right point. Walks the line. Back to Stone. Indirect pass received by Smith. Pestered by Tetro, who took a shoulder up high. Ended up dragging Smith out to the neutral zone. Bond across for Smith. Wrist shot. Blocked in front. Trickle towards McCollum, and Pamelaan headbands Ratcliffe. Tetro on the right side, lofted for him, too far in front. He beats Smith to the puck. They leave it in the corner, and Stone pries it free. More than midway through the second period, 4-3 Hattricks with the lead. They have outscored Binghamton 2-1 in this period, but Yates, with the most recent tally, has Binghamton within one. Hattricks had their largest lead of the game at 4-2, about 6 minutes in to this period. We've had a timeout here inside the DIA. Hattricks 4, Black Bears 3. You're watching it live on the Hattricks Digital Network.
Clancy Moving and Relocation. Moving is stressful, but it doesn't have to be. Call Clancy and let them do the heavy lifting for you. Resident and commercial services plus other services such as storage. Remember, Clancy is fancy.
Todd Maserati Alfa Romeo of Danbury is the premier automobile partner in the Danbury area. Located on Newtown Road, the Bennett family has been putting the community behind the wheel for over 35 years. Dream big, drive a Maserati or Alfa Romeo. New and pre-owned vehicles available. Let Todd Maserati Alfa Romeo of Danbury be your choice.
Dowler Garage in New Preston specializes in batteries, brakes, and general service. When you're stuck, you're in luck. Call Mike so you don't need a bike. Dowler Garage.
Peach Wave of Bethel. Located on Greenwood Avenue in Bethel, Peach Wave is your place to go for a quality treat. Frozen yogurt and toppings, it doesn't get much better. Catch a wave, a peach one.
God bless America here inside the Danbury Ice Arena. One of the special festivities going on for Alumni Night here in Danbury. Honoring one of the former Danbury teams. .9-12 remaining, second period. 4-3 Hattricks in front. They have scored twice in this period. Binghamton with the latest tally to pull back within one. Face off to the right of McCollum. It's Falenga and Logar. Binghamton wins. Point shot blocked. Rebound off the bleed of Somero. And Brendan Young turbos out of the zone, chugging ahead. And dangling at the line was Fitzgerald for Binghamton. Picking it off at center, it's Kyle Steffen dropping off. Fitzgerald follows at the right point, pass inside, detected by Young, a jitterbug. Leads Woolley out through center. Woolley closed off by Weber, and the puck lifted off the glass. Somero beats Abdella to it, chips it, gets there, and Abdella swiped it away at the last moment with one hand on his stick. 8.5 remaining, second period. One goal, Hattricks lead. Young cross-checked from behind. Puck was left. And Falenga, who scored tonight, leaves off for Woolley. Back for Falenga, right corner. Up top, Henning, wrist shot! Stopped by Egbert, grazed off the blocker. Young in his second game as a Hattrick. Crunch to the boards by Logar. Double-teamed, helping out McKittrick, prize it free. Hamalayan left point. Across for Henning, fumbled, got it back, rims it around. McKittrick surveying, has some room. Up top, out of the zone, Pamelaan was backtracking. ZP steps over the red line, slingshots it in. Behind the play, Cunningham took a spill. He's back to his skates. And Danbury reorganizes. Henning's outlet pass all the way down, hit off of Egbert's stick, but it was an icing nonetheless, and the faceoff all the way back in the hat-trick zone. The emotions of tonight, with it being alumni night and facing the top team in the Empire Division, number two team in the league. Hat-tricks still have an opportunity to catch Motor City for second place in the Empire Division. Come in tonight 9 points behind the Rockers, who last I checked are trailing in their game tonight. Cunningham lost possession. Walters, low right, centering try through everyone. Oliveri in the left corner. Sauces for Yates at the right point. Angles it off the boards. Kirkby beats Henning to the puck. Turns middle. Taken down. Delayed penalty. Anderson dropping off. Walters walks the line. Low left, Anderson for Kirkby. Airmailed it. Binghamton keeps it alive, extra skater on. Yates for Walters, fakes the shot, dishes off Yates. Feather down low for Kirkby. Searching for a lane, opts for Walters straight away. Back for Kirkby, one-timer, stopped by McCullum, and no rebound. And the Black Bears head to their second power play of the night. They are 0-for-1, came back in the first period. 5-minute opportunity it was following a boarding on Justin Henning. Now the penalty right now is a trip on Corey Cunningham. The time of the penalty, 13:27. And Binghamton's second-ranked power play coming into tonight gets a crack at it. Their second try. Opportunity to tie the game. Off the faceoff, Yates swerves middle. Around, shot off the side of the net. Pops to Harwell, and he kisses it off the glass all the way down, 15 seconds off the power play. As we're inching closer to 6 minutes left in the period. 3 goals in this period. 4 in the first. 2 apiece in the opening frame, 2 for the hat-tricks here on the second, and 1 for Binghamton, looking for the equalizer. Bond return for Kirkby, they play catch. Bond defended by Harwell, wrist shot, blocked down by the leg pad of Abdellah. And here come the hat-trick shorthanded. Harwell has 2 goals tonight, drops for Ratcliffe, pulls, shoots, missed the net. LaBelle corrals and smartly dumps it in. Hat-tricks forwards get a change, and now all 4 have been replaced. It's Ruiz, McKittrick, Yao, and Henning on the ice. Logar and Yao collide at the blue line, and it's batted out by Ruiz and all the way down with 40 seconds on Binghamton's second power play of the night. Jesse Anderson, the leading assist man for Binghamton, sets up Connor Smith, who wheels through the neutral zone, slips it across for Samarow. Crisscrosses with Logar, dropped off Stone, wrist shot! Whizzes wide, clanks off the end boards. Anderson climbing the wall, picks it up on the near side. Up top, Stone. Hands off for Smith. His pass across, blocked. Logar for Smith, touched for Stone, and the shot grazes off the mask of McCullum. Second time that's happened tonight. Get some cheers from the Animal House to his right. And the hat-tricks kill off the penalty. Cunningham, fresh out of the box. Sets up Falanga left side. Twirls back, looking for reinforcements. LaBelle shoots wide. Woolley, left corner. Sachets pass Anderson. Puck squirts to Cunningham. To the back, Abdellah. Left point, wrister. Off the glove of Egbert. And into the protective netting. With about 4:10 to go, second period, hat-tricks for Black Bears 3. You're watching it live on the Hat-Tricks Digital Network.
Reverie Brewing Company is a featured beverage in the Danbury Ice Arena. Grab a Reverie and don't quit your daydream. When you drink Reverie, anything is possible.
Set Fitness is the official gym and training center of the Danbury Hat-Tricks. Pump iron or tone up. Join Set Fitness and be the best you.
Mitchell, experience the difference. Mitchell has served the community since 1945. Heating oil, propane, and service for your home or business. Mitchell is ready to serve.
Oak Ridge Waste and Recycling has the roots in the community for all of your needs. Residential and commercial, Oak Ridge is the official sanitation partner of the Danbury Hattricks.
Hat City Physical Therapy is Danbury, Connecticut's leading provider of physical therapy and orthopedic specialists. Their highly skilled and caring team of licensed therapy providers are focused and committed to restoring your health and well-being so that you can return to the life you enjoy.
Hattricks holding on to a one-goal lead. 4:08 on the clock, second period. Doug Latuca with you here inside the Danbury Ice Arena. Thanks for joining us on a Saturday night. First game of two for the Hattricks this weekend. They're back in action tomorrow against Elmira. This is the 15th of 18 meetings between the two teams this season. Harwell has two goals tonight. Turns, wheels it around the kick plate, too far for Ratcliffe. And the Black Bears tap it out to center. Pamelaean starts the up, intercepted by Fletcher up the right side. Fletcher inside, one-timer blocked. Kyle Steffen, in his first game as a Black Bear, nearly tied the game up. Mentioned Steffen graduated from American International University in 2020. Hasn't played competitively in about 4 years. But he's in the lineup tonight for Binghamton. Getting some minutes late here in the second. Falanga, he scored back in the first period out there with Stoichevsky. And for the moment, Ratcliffe, who heads to the bench. Stoichevsky dangles around, cuts to the net. Egbert's down, puck's free. Stoichevsky whacking at it. He took a stick up high. He's holding his face to the left of the net. Meanwhile, Binghamton the other way. Kirkby steps over the line. Centering pass elevated. Stoichevsky gliding to the bench with his head down. Puck is free. And now they blow it dead. Hattricks would have had a breakaway the other way. Stoichevsky had gotten back to the bench already, and a player had hopped on for the Hattricks. Would have been a clear breakaway if they connected on a pass, but instead they blow it dead, which I understand. You would blow the play dead if Stoichevsky was still down on the ice, and you have to wait until the Hattricks have possession. Now, there's no penalty here at all. Stoichevsky's on the ground. Six are flying. The puck was right near his head. And you can even see him take a whack at the puck and miss. And a Black Bear stick hit him right in the face. He is back on the bench. And Billy McCreary and John Krapinski barking at the officials. They cannot believe the call because that cost the Hattricks a breakaway opportunity. A chance for them to reinstate their two-goal advantage. The shots are 25-19 Hattricks. It's 4-3 Danbury with under three to play in the middle period. Hattricks jumped out to a two-goal advantage at 5:54 of this period, but Binghamton with an answer about a minute and a half later to cut the deficit to one. A scrum behind the play to the right of McCullough. Meanwhile, the Hattricks in the offensive zone. Ruiz left side. Gets it back from McKittrick, centering pass through. Tyler Noseworthy out there with Daniel McKittrick and Johnny Ruiz. Mentioned Noseworthy, a celebrity contract tonight. Hattricks dressing 11 forwards and 6 defensemen. One of the rare games where the Hattricks are not being penalized for a suspension. And have put forth a full roster tonight. And Noseworthy's played on 3 of the 5 pro teams in Danbury, last appearing in 2021-22 with the Hattricks. Only played 7 games. His best season in Danbury was 12-13 with the Whalers, 50 points in 34 games. Right now, he's actually the general manager of the NA3HL Hattrick squad and the assistant coach and assistant GM of the NAHL team. He's stepped to the bench. No, he's on the ice with McKittrick and Ruiz still. They have not changed. We've dipped under 2 minutes to go in a one-goal contest. Second period. Logar glides over center. Cross-corner dump. Yao retrieves. Lost it off the side of the net. It spits to the near corner. Stone across for Bond, fakes the shot, dips the shoulder, back for Stone, wrist shot wide, and it rims around for DiNicola. In stride up the left wing, turns on the brakes, locates Ratcliffe, and here's Henning. In stride, Bond and Henning collide in the corner. It's swiped along the boards, outlet pass, tape to tape, Samarov. One on three, chips and changes. Yao back for it for Danbury. His outlet intercepted, a log jam for it. They play ping pong, Thompson hauled down. We play on, Ratcliffe elevated for DiNicola, gloved it and tried to separate himself. He ran right into Fitzgerald. Final 45 of the second period. Utoro dangles at the line, sends it across for Thompson. Henning, one hands to the corner. Ratcliffe in the final 35 of the period. It's skied through center. Fitzgerald zipping through center. Centers for Utoro. It was intercepted in a hit lead along the boards behind the play. And icing on the hat-tricks. And I believe they've just called a penalty on Chase Harwell for the hit he laid on Colin Fitzgerald. Or have they? Now the arm went up a little late after the hit, but it might have just been an icing indication. So they are picking players off the hat-tricks bench who changed after the icing. 19.3, the official reading on the clock. Face off at the far circle. It's Young and Kirkby, and the rookie forward beats the veteran captain of Binghamton in an important D-zone draw. Anderson's lead pass finds Oliveri, and he slapped it wide. Play was offsides anyway. So the whistle blows. And the last of the second period upcoming. Face off at the far dot outside the hat-trick zone. Danbury can make changes. And now captain versus captain on the draw. Ruiz clapped it forward and a whistle. Slowly making our way to the end of this second period. Yates in for the draw now. Ruiz jams it forward, pops in the air. It's bunted into the hat-trick zone, and that is it for the second period here in Danbury. What a game we've got going on so far. Hat-tricks outscore the Black Bears 2-1 in the period. They lead Binghamton 4-3 through 40 minutes here inside the DIA. And you have to imagine that period number three.
Get your tickets through the end of the second intermission.
Will be must-watch television, and we'll have it for you right here on the Hat-Tricks Digital Network. Danbury wearing the Titans-themed jerseys on Alumni Night, putting on a show for the fans and the alumni, old and new. Opening game of this weekend set for the Hat-Tricks. They do not play Binghamton tomorrow. It is Elmira coming to town. At the team that is chasing the Hat-Tricks for third place in the Empire Division. And the Hat-Tricks have played some tight games against Binghamton this season. If you look back at it, there's only been a couple of blowouts. And even in the games where the score is 2-3-4 goals apart, a lot of those goals have been late in a game, empty net goals that have inflated the score. And a lot of outsiders might think that Binghamton has dominated the Hattricks this season, which just really isn't the case. And they have gotten the better of the Hattricks, but Danbury has held its own against the top team in the division by far. And they got off to the sluggish 1-6 start against Binghamton, then rattled off three consecutive wins and four victories in the last seven against Binghamton, but have losses in three of the last four versus the Black Bears. Now, these teams will play each other again three more times, all in April. It's almost how the Hattricks finish off their season. Three of the final four games versus Binghamton in the first two weekends of April. Two in Binghamton on the 5th and 6th, and the season regular season finale on the 12th here in Danbury. It's the TK's American Cafe center ice shot. Five free wings for the winner. And that one looks good. She got it. Bullseye. First shot and six free wings for everyone. I might have to use that this week. Shout out to my good friend Ian Unsworth. He'll be stopping by in the Danbury area on his way to New Hampshire. And we will be sitting down at TK's American Cafe. Might see another good friend, Tom Kennedy. I'd have to show him over to Twister's Ice Cream Cafe as well. Introduce him to the whole crew here in Danbury. But 76 amazing wing flavors, and now it's the Todd Maserati Alfa Romeo Chuck-a-Puck. You know, we've got some experts in the stands. It's a gift. It's a talent. They've worked on it game after game after game. I don't believe one has found the bottom of the can. Now, I was off the last time. Two slipped by my view. I have not seen one go quite yet. And that's one. There we go. From the upper deck. Nice shot. One winner. You know they don't want to split the prize. Who wants to split a prize when you can come away with all of it? A bounce attempt. Lots of pucks near the can, not many inside, just one, I believe. And that is it. They will end the contest. I see just one, maybe a second. Oh, off the front of the can. They really want to split the prize. They're still going. Oh, they turned the music off and everything. Oh, that one just short. Last opportunity at the buzzer. Bounced off the front. Another opportunity. And he is short. They're still going. They must have bought three or four bags worth of pucks. I mean, they are still firing them. I believe that's a newcomer in the group. Now, I mentioned you have the professional chuck-a-puckers. And I don't think
we got two pucks
that our good friends made anything in the basket. But I could be wrong.
Where's Leo? Well, we got 114. 114. Usually
114.
He's not here today. He's got prob or something. 846. 8-4. Look, this guy, James Gennarelli.
We got them both.
He wins every day.
Unbelievable.
That's Todd Maserati, Alfa Romeo.
Unbelievable. They did it again. I was wrong. I got to get my eyes checked, I think, because I'm not tracking these pucks going to the can because I missed them on Sunday, and today I thought there was only one in there, and I didn't think that our friends right in front of me got any of them. They ended up going home with two. So they get the full prize. Good for them. They seem to get some sort of the prize every night.
His father's the coach.
Todd Maserati, Alfa Romeo.
Kenny got to pick his number first. He's the son of the coach. All right, that's Todd Mazzarotti on Raw Mail.
And that is the chuck-a-puck in between the second and third period here inside the Danbury Ice Arena. What a contest we've got cooking up for you. It's 4-3 hat tricks. 40 minutes are in the books. Second intermission, Doug Letuca with you. We will step aside. You're watching Saturday night, Danbury Hat Tricks Hockey on the Hat Tricks Digital Network.
I gotta catch those. I gotta work on my hands.
This guy.
We'll be right back.
heart is a blue. Shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of luck, and the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck, and you're not moving anywhere. You thought you found a friend to take you out of this place, someone you could lend a hand in return for grace. It's a beautiful.
Here we go. Period three from inside the Danbury Ice Arena, and we've got a one-goal game. Hattricks clinging on to a 3-4, a 4-3 advantage over the Binghamton Black Bears. Hello again, Hattricks fans. Doug Latuca with you. Thanks so much for joining us on a Saturday night from Danbury. Hattricks and Black Bears round 15 out of 18 this season, and the first game of a weekend set for the Hattricks. Although they do not play Binghamton tomorrow, it is Elmira coming to town for a 3 o'clock puck drop. Black Bears are off tomorrow afternoon. Hattricks winners of 6 of the last 8 games. Binghamton victories in 5 of the last 6. For Binghamton, they've topped the Hattricks in 3 of the last 4 games. But the stat that we mentioned off the top, in every game that the Hattricks have scored 4 or more goals this season, they have beaten the Black Bears. Right now, they have 4. Their only other win this season against Binghamton, they have 5, where they did not score 4-plus goals, was back on October 20th. First meeting between the teams, a 3-2 shootout win here in Danbury. So, the other 4 victories, they've scored 4-plus goals, and the majority of them, they've gotten past regulation. Now, yes, 2 points helps the Hattricks, but 3 is preferred, with Danbury still chasing Motor City, 9 points behind entering tonight. I'll try and get a Motor City score update at the next break. Hattricks and Black Bears, final 20 minutes of regulation, and we are underway. Danbury in front, 4-3. Hattricks started the scoring all the way back in the first period at 2:16. Binghamton answered 21 seconds later, then stormed out to a 2-1 lead. Hattricks tied the game, actually rattled off 3 straight goals to push in front 4-2. But Binghamton, with the most recent goal, to pull within 1. 30 seconds gone, third period. Don Oliveri dishes for Gavin Yates, twisting on Dustin Henning, and wheels it below the goal line. Andrew Logar in pursuit, whiffed on the clear around. Yao pushing it forward. Logjam at the point, wrist shot off the back glass. Henning sprints after it, chips it up the boards. Fitzgerald over skates with McKittrick pestering him. Cunningham tossing Fitzgerald to the side, and here goes the rookie forward. Inside-outside move, pocket picked by Weber, and Fitzgerald angles it off the boards. It's soccered ahead by Jared Yao, and it spits back for one of the alternate captains, Jared Yao. Some real estate in front, over the Hattricks logo at center, cross-corner dump, darts to the bench for a change, 1:20 in to the third period, shots 25-24, Hattricks holding on to a one-goal lead. Connor Smith targeting Somero too far in front, and an icing on the Black Bears sets up a face-off deep in Binghamton territory. Hattricks 24 points behind Binghamton in the Empire Division. Black Bears in first, Hattricks are in third. Now Danbury more concerned with the Rockers, who, as we mentioned a couple minutes ago, are just 9 points ahead of the Hattricks for second place. Point shot from Pamelain, fought off by Egbert. Turnaround bid, chopped towards goal. Squirts to Stoichevsky. The lefty on his backhand shielding the puck, dropped off for Pamelain, who would backtrack to the neutral zone. Play would have been offsides. And instead, Binghamton ices the puck yet again. Couple of highlights on the Hattricks goals tonight. Johnny Ruiz's 150th FPHL goal, and now second in the league with 31 goals. Michael Falanga snapping 18 games without a goal, scored the second tally for the Hattricks, and Chase Harwell with the most recent 2 for Danbury. Scored 2 minutes between each other. Here's Cunningham shooting, and Egbert barely held on. Glued it to his right arm with the glove on top. Nolan Egbert, 42 for 44 back on February 25th against the Hattricks in a Black Bears 4-2 victory. Mentioned Binghamton has won three of the last four against the Hattricks, but in a bit of a larger sample size, the last seven, the Hattricks with four wins. Off the draw, Ruiz won it forward. It spits to McKittrick, turn, shoots! Deflected wide. Henning activates from the left point. Pitchforks it below the goal line. Yates slides it, kept in by Cunningham for McKittrick in his skates. And off to the races is Fletcher. Shields off Yao, left the puck behind. Thompson supporting, and McKittrick shovels out to center. As we've played 2.5 minutes, period three, one goal, Hattricks advantage. JT Walters, Binghamton's leading penalty minute receiver. The big defenseman takes it wide, centers. DiNicola stole it away. Off to the races up the right wing. Ratcliffe slams it in, and Egbert carefully played it for Anderson. DiNicola with a few assists tonight. Ratcliffe with two. Here's Anderson. Dropping off, Yates shoots. Glove save, McCollum. Yates back on it. Chris crosses, Kirkby left point, winds. Shot blocked by Ratcliffe, batted for DiNicola. Hattricks with numbers if they hurry. DiNicola up the right side, looking for reinforcements. LaBelle off his blade. Black Bears collide. Ratcliffe on it, spins off a check. Stone presses him to the glass. And it's directed out to center by Yates. Chased from behind by Harwell. Yates steps over the line. Through the legs. Backhand. Pass! Underneath McCollum. He's got it. A dangerous situation. Puck nearly on the goal line. And McCollum shuts the wickets to preserve the one-goal advantage. That puck off of a Hattrick stick in front. And the score remains 4-3. Brendan Young chugging the legs up the left wing. Was turned away. And it's sent back in. Samaro and Tetro collide in the far corner. Stone keeps at the right point. Samaro, the righty. Poke checked off the puck by Tetro. Samaro straightaway. Stone shoots. Blocked by Tetro, who was a couple feet in front of McCollum. Binghamton still on it. Bond. Across, Stone collects, shoots, gobbled up by McCollum, and no rebound. Hattricks 4, Black Bears 3. We've played a little over 4 minutes here in the third period, and fans, do you like your grass green or do you want weeds? Yard Goats Landscaping and Construction services Fairfield and Litchfield County. Their specialties are tree service, excavation, patios, decks, and making your grass happy. Check out yardgoats.io and get green with the team. Yard Goats sponsors the starting lineups. Right before puck drop here in Danbury. The Hattricks with their starters on. Top line of Ruiz, Cunningham, and McKittrick. Yao and Henning are the D pair. Fitzgerald fumbles at the blue line, dragged it out, brought it back in. Binghamton must touch up, and they do. Henning stops, turns on the Jets, gains the red line. Egbert out of the zone, rims it around. Thompson angles it. Chasing after it is Steffen. And LaBelle launches. Does it have the legs for icing? It does, but we've hit the first timeout here in period number 3. Danbury 4, Binghamton 3. 5:02 off the clock here in the third. We'll step aside of the Hattricks Digital Network.
Hope Plumbing offers a full range of commercial and residential services. Their team can assist you in all aspects of any plumbing-related needs you have. You have hope with Hope Plumbing.
Kellogg Hardwood Lumber, located in Bethel, has the hardwoods for any project. They are a kiln-dried hardwood lumber yard and manufacturing facility carrying the highest quality hardwoods available. Flooring, moldings, cabinets, furniture, or whatever you are building, they have the kiln-dried hardwoods you need.
Since 1881, Omaha Beef Company has been supplying the Danbury community with meat and beef. Located on Maple Avenue, they are now the featured product in the Danbury Ice Arena. When you say Omaha Beef Company, you mean top of the line.
Bold Move Logistics is a family-owned and operated delivery service provider exclusively for Amazon. As a team, they deliver packages the last mile to your doorstep. Check them out on the concourse level at the Danbury Arena and inquire about joining their team.
One goal hockey game, 5:02 into the third period. Doug Latuca with you on the Hattrick Digital Network. Danbury in front by one against the top team of the Empire Division. 3 points up for grabs. Oliveri off the draw, flings it wide. McCullough might have got a piece. Big news around the league. The Watertown Wolves defeating the Motor City Rockers 3-1 earlier on tonight. That matters because the Hattricks chasing the Rockers for second place in the Empire. With 3 points tonight, the Hattricks will creep within six of Motor City. And unfortunate for Danbury, they do not see Motor City again this season. Left circle draw, Harwell beats Kirkby. Puck kissed off the glass, out of play, deflected. So no penalty. Face-off right back in the Hattrick zone. These teams will meet up again in April. Three of the final four regular season games for the Hattricks are against Binghamton, two in Binghamton, and the season finale here in Danbury. Hattricks have played a very difficult schedule when you play the top team in the Empire, number two team overall in the league, 18 times. That could be tricky. Shot from the right circle, slapped over the net and into the net. And McCullum actually ducked his head out of the way as that shot whistled out of play. No harm, no foul. Another D-zone faceoff for the Hattricks. Trying to make it. Seven wins in the last nine games. Face-off to the left of McCullum. It's Harwell and Kirkby. Binghamton won it, but Di Nicola chips and chases after Fitzgerald, who swerves out of danger, angles it for Kirkby, through both Kirkby and LaBelle on goal McCullum. He'll sling it out to center, and Fitzgerald. Cross-ice pass, Ratcliffe leads Harwell, two-on-one. Across, blocked by Fitzgerald. The young defenseman playing in his first game for Binghamton this season, third season overall for Fitzgerald with the Black Bears. But his first game tonight, and practically taking the spot of Jake Schultz, who is no longer with Binghamton. The 6'6 D-man, Josh LaBelle, headmans Falanga. Pass intended for Woolley. Falanga shouldering Weber. Walters bangs it for Oliveri. And Anderson pushes it in. LaBelle ramp try. Fan Smith in front. Rolls on goal. McCullum's got it underneath his glove. And no rebound after a couple of whacks near that right post. Shots are even at 27. The stands, as full as they've been all season on a special alumni night here in Danbury. Festivities at the first intermission, video tributes throughout the first period. That in the rearview mirror, and now 3 points up for grabs. Ruiz and Somero for the draw. Hattrick's captain wins it. Puck kissed off the glass. McKittrick retrieves, steps over the red line in stride. Cunningham up the gut, swept away by Walters. Cunningham hops on top for McKittrick. Off his stick, Tetro steps. His stick shatters. Ruiz from an awkward angle. Puck flips into the Animal House and out of play. It's not been as chippy as we anticipated.
I mentioned this is the 15th meeting of the season between the two teams. And past beefs tend to boil to the surface on a night like tonight in a one-goal game. Early on, we had a little post-whistle pushing and shoving, but not lately. Shot ramps off a stick from McKittrick and out of play. We're right back on the air tomorrow. 3 o'clock puck drop. Elmira is in town. It starts three straight against Elmira. One on the 10th, and then two on the 15th and 16th. Those are the final two games of the Hattrick's nine-game homestand. It's the seventh of nine. And the Hattrick's played very well at home during that span. McCollum stops Utoro on a snapper from the left circle. No rebound for Connor McCollum, who tonight has stopped 24 of 27 shots. Connor making his eighth start in the last 10 games. He's faced 31-plus shots in three straight games, approaching that number at 27 right now. And this, the 10th start for Connor against Binghamton this season. He has three of the Hattrick's five wins. Liam Murray with the other two. Harwell sauces for Ratcliffe, waits, shot it wide. DiNicola got a piece, but not enough to direct it towards goal. Thompson flings it in. Utoro centers all the way through, and DiNicola at the defensive blue line rainbows it out to center. Binghamton trying to catch the Hattrick's in a change. Woolley got back, lost the puck. Utoro, straightaway Stone, shoots wide! Had some room to the right of McCollum and was off target. Hattrick's have outscored their opponents 27-21 during the homestand. Here's Yates, the lefty. Off the boards, Bond fakes the shot. Yates back for Bond. Oliveri, toe drags around LaBelle, centers. Stone shoots, blocked by Young. Falanga out in front, but Young leads the rush up the right side. Kirkby, one-hand effort. Nullified his opportunity, but Young still on it. Woolley, low left for LaBelle at the point. Wrist shot, blocked down. Woolley could not corral, and Yates out the other way. Oliveri at the ring of the circle unloads one off the shoulder of McCollum. Logar creeping in across off the blade of Yates. Weber tiptoeing the line, kept it in. His point shot off the stick of Woolley. Fitzgerald skate to stick at the point, flutters one on McCollum. Knocked it down with the catching mitt, and LaBelle outlets Young at the red line, nudges it into Binghamton territory. Approaching the midway point, third period, one goal Hattrick's lead. Abdella chipping, LaBelle batting to center, and Weber fumbled, races after it, and Egbert helping out his defenseman leads the break. Logar rims it around from far to near side. Smith settles the juggling puck, centers. There goes McKittrick up the gut. Pass from Cunningham, too hot to handle. And Logar streaking through center. Around Ruiz, pass into the middle. Cunningham to Tex, and Tetro zips in. His wrist shot waffled out to the blue line by Egbert, but not out. Tetro slams it around Walters, out of his reach. And Hattrick's get it below the goal line. Egbert's stick got knocked out of his hand, but Logar placed it right back in his blocker hand. Icing on Binghamton, but a timeout here in Danbury. Still a one-goal Hattrick's advantage. You don't want to go anywhere. Hattrick's hockey live here on the Hattrick's Digital Network.
Charter Oak Brewing Company is a Connecticut-based brewery featuring handcrafted and innovative beers such as pale ales, lagers, India pale ales, brown ales, sours, and several seasonal, more robust beers. Pick one up at the Rabbit Hole.
Danbury Pace, Chipman, Mizuko, and Emerson is your partner for the road ahead. They provide comprehensive legal guidance for individuals, families, and businesses. CME, let the pros handle your needs.
Domino's, the official pizza of the Danbury Hat-Tricks. Thin crust, pepperoni, sausage, you name the topping, and they got it. Domino's, they deliver.
Partner with Fastenal to simplify and secure your supply chain needs. They handle a vast range of industrial products, and if you want it, they can get it. The core belief is in the people at Fastenal. They empower their teams to do great things for yours.
Grounds Donut House is the featured donut of the Danbury Ice Arena. Stop by the main stand and grab yourself one of today's featured donuts. As good as it gets. Donut, miss out.
9:21 remaining in regulation. Hat-Tricks 4, Black Bears 3. Doug Latuca with you on the Hat-Tricks Digital Network. Thanks for stopping by. What a night it has been. Alumni old and new in the stands. Ceremony at the first intermission. Video tributes. And a one-goal hockey game down the stretch. Hat-Tricks have scored 3-plus goals in 6 of the 8 games. 6 of the last 8 games, and they are perfect in those contests. Now, we mentioned the stat in terms of the hat-trick scoring 4-plus against Binghamton. So they have tallied both boxes tonight in terms of offense. 4-plus against Binghamton and 3-plus overall, and they lead by 1 goal. DeNicole, the forward, charging after it. Stefan on his back, but Yao clanks it off the glass. Harwell picks it off up the left side, has 2 goals tonight. Inside, Ratcliffe shoots off the end boards, was deflected. And Binghamton starts the rush, an outlet for Thompson out of his reach, and Abdellah quick for LaBelle, touch to Harwell, and in deep with 8.5 on the clock. Patrick searching for their 7th win in the last 9 games. Offsides on Binghamton. Gavin Yates was navigating the line. And a step off. Shots are pretty even. 28-27. Hat-Tricks with the slight edge. Same result on the scoreboard. Stoichevsky, Woolley, and Falanga the line for the Hat-Tricks up front with LaBelle and Abdellah the D pair. Binghamton with Oliveri, Yates, and Kirkby. Fitzgerald and Weber on defense. Oliveri dancing in, shielding the puck, hands off Kirkby. Winds, drags, Abdellah poke checked it away, and he starts the rush from left to right. Abdellah inside. Too high for Stoichevsky to settle down, but Stoge back on it, into the middle for Woolley Fan. Here's Pamelayan, faked the shot, Abdellah needed a change. Pamelayan wanted that pass. Tetra replaces Abdellah. Pamelayan, wrist shot, stop, rebound, Woolley shoot save. They're whack away, Falanga was denied by Egbert, who flops on top of it to get the whistle. Now the Hat-Tricks during this homestand have lost twice. Once in regulation to Binghamton back on February 25th, and their most recent game, a 3-2 defeat in overtime to Port Huron last Sunday. But Hat-Tricks getting healthy, players returning from suspension, and since the weekend trip to Watertown, 3 games, the Hat-Tricks have turned on the heat during this playoff push. Can they close out a 1-goal victory? Jesse Anderson to the net, stuff in try, flips over the goal to the far corner. Walters, point shot off the skate of Tetro. Pamelayan and Logar. Behind the net, Logar, low to high. Anderson wheels it around. Cunningham. Beat to the puck by Walters. Pamelayan.
Too soft off the board. Smith kept in front. Samaro robbed. Rebound Samaro. Turns, shoots, and scores. First shot denied. Second opportunity over the right pad of McCollum. And this game is tied at four. Justin Samaro would not be denied his fifth goal of the season. And the equalizer. Right when you think the hat tricks can close out one of these tight contests in regulation, the other team finds the back of the net. We saw it all of last weekend against Port here on hat tricks. Came away with two victories on both the Friday and the Saturday. And then we're topped on Sunday. Now Binghamton buzzing, looking for the go-ahead goal. The Black Bears last led in the first period, 2-1. Here's Ratcliffe, shoots wide! Had Egbert moving from right to left. Hattricks keep it in the zone, but Kirkby dishes it off the glass. Abdella chasing. D2D LaBelle launches. Oliveri swats it down. No high stick, so we play on. Harwell already has two tonight, charging through. Stone stopped him, and Harwell finishes his check in the far corner. The goal, Samaro at 13-19, has us level at four. Yao, off the boards, took a hit, made a play, actually dumped Fletcher in the process, and then almost took out Egbert when he lost an edge. Thompson, lots of room in front. Feathers it below the goal line. Steffen and Woolley collide. Yao crunching Steffen behind the net. Outlet pass in the skates of Woolley. Kicks it to himself. Henning touches it for Stoichevsky. Hattrick's offsides. They didn't touch the puck, but they blow it dead. And some stick whacking after the whistle. 5:19, the reading on the clock. Third period. Tie. Hockey game. Hattricks led 1-0, 2:16 in. Binghamton scored the next two. Hattricks rattled off three unanswered. And now Binghamton on a two-goal run. One in the second, and the lone goal here in the third period. Samaro at 13-19. Face off at the far dot. Ruiz and Logar. Pops in the air, juggling puck. McKittrick shoveled it, hit off Fitzgerald, who slips it in. McCollum out of the net, handed it off for Pamela Lane. Bit of a miscommunication. Hattrick survived for the moment. Weaver swats it in. McKittrick, outlet for Cunningham, across for Ruiz, with under five to play here in the third. Cunningham, backhand centering try. Samaro knocked it down. Turnover, Cunningham kicking, looking, Ruiz spins, puck in the crease, and Egbert's got it in his glove, and we are at the final timeout of regulation. 4-4 the score. What else could you ask for on a Saturday night from Danbury? Don't go anywhere. Hattricks Hockey, final 5 minutes right here on the Hattricks Digital Network.
Tixer is the official ticketing partner of the Danbury Hattricks and Danbury Ice Arena. Log on and get your seats today. Great service and easy to use.
Tri-State Legacy Group is an insurance group that focuses on putting your family needs first. Consult with them today and set your plan for the future. They care about people over products. It's that simple.
Twister's Ice Cream Cafe. Located in New Fairfield, Twister's features 32 different flavors of ice cream. This season, they are stationed in the Danbury Ice Arena. Stop by and visit their stand. Get sprinkled.
New Haven Nighthawk Brewing. Brewed right here in Connecticut and featured at the Rabbit Hole. New Haven Night Brewing Company is the beverage of choice at the Danbury Arena. Grab a cold one and party like you're in the Elm City.
Down the stretch we go. 4:41 on the clock. We are level at four. Doug Latuca with you on a Saturday night from downtown Danbury. Hattricks in search of a critical 3 points. Rockers have already lost tonight. 3 points would bring the Hattricks within six of Motor City for second place in the Empire Division. Binghamton has all but locked up the top spot. Hattricks at one point led 4-2 in the second, about 6 minutes in. But Binghamton with the most recent two goals at 7:13 of the second. And here in the third at 13:19. They've tied it. Here's Harwell shooting, kicked out. The play was offsides anyway. So a bit of a clock reset. Back to 4:11. And they'll bring the faceoff all the way back into the hat-trick zone to the left of Connor McCullum, who tonight has stopped 28 of 32 Binghamton shots. As for Egbert, he is 27 for 31. Hat-tricks fans had become familiar with Connor McAnanima, but over the last two games, it's been Nolan Egbert, the Long Island native. Tonight, the hat-trick's getting to him for four goals, which is usually the recipe for success against Binghamton. Danbury has yet to lose a game when they've scored four or more goals against Binghamton this season. That play appeared offsides, nothing called. Harwell guarding the puck and shovels it in deep. Woolley in pursuit, beats Fletcher to it. Up top, yeah, Wine shoots! Glove save Egbert, and no rebound. With no hat-tricks standing in front.
Let's hear it. Make some noise.
Hattricks with two wins, one loss to start March. It all goes back to last weekend against Port Huron. Looking for another victory at home tonight. Seventh game of this nine-game homestand for the Hattricks. Game eight during that stretch. Tomorrow at 3:00 against Elmira, who's fighting for their playoff lives. Skate with the Hattricks postgame. Free kids club ticket, and it's Scouts Night. Find all the information on DanburyHattricks.com. We're under 3:20 to play, third period. 4-4 the score. Puck swept out to the neutral zone. Henning standing up Thompson. Yates dips the shoulder. Rather, that's Uturo. Both have a two as the second number in their total number. Uturo 92 and Yates 12. Thompson sockers it to himself. Hemmed in by Henning. Bond keeps to the left point. Shoots, blocked by a kneeling Yao. Slapper Logar pinballs around and spits to the far side. Cunningham. Outlet for Ruiz. Corrals off the boards. Bond back on defense. Puck juggling. Sticks being lifted. Cunningham. Centering pass. Denied. Cunningham double teamed. Flips it far side. Pamelaan. Into the middle. Stone. Got to it first. And Smith up the left side. Tetro shoving him. And the rookie D-man takes the puck right from Smith. Approaching 2 minutes on the clock. McKittrick sauces it in. Tetro triple teamed in the corner. Hattricks making changes. Fans with a let's go Hattricks chant. Fitzgerald. Stick check by LaBelle. Samaro, who tied the game at 13:19 of this period. Smith. Snipped it down low, Samaro. Pressed on by Tetro. Finishes his check in the far corner. Both players down on the ice. Loose puck. Harwell poking it. It's in the skates of Weaver. Harwell with two goals tonight. Puck pops in the air. Harwell and Weaver rolling on the ground below the goal line behind the play. Yates up the right wing. LaBelle knocks it off his stick. Yates regathers. 1:10 to go. Abdella off the glass and out. Final minute of regulation. Kirkby, right wing, centers. And Falanga got back Yates reared back for a one-timer, could not connect. Woolley sends it back for Abdella. Shots 33-32 Binghamton. 4-4 the score. Next goal likely the winner. Puck hops on LaBelle. Gets a lucky bounce. Trickles out to center, under 30 on the clock. Walters pressured by Stoichevsky. Centers, Fletcher picked it off. 20 seconds to go. Up the left side, Fletcher around Henning. Yao closes him off. To the back, Walters with 10. Wrist shot, tipped over the net. Woolley angles it off the boards into the Binghamton end. And 60 minutes, not enough here in Danbury. Bonus hockey on what has already been a long night here in Danbury, approaching 10 o'clock here in Connecticut. But who is complaining? What a night so far in the Hat City. Alumni night, getting treated to an overtime contest. Hat tricks this season, past regulation, have lost four times in overtime, once in a shootout, but have six wins after regulation, five in a shootout, and two in overtime. And on home ice, the Hat tricks have played in nine games, needing extra time. The Hat tricks have won six of those, four in a shootout, and two in overtime. And if you go back to the Hat tricks history with Binghamton, Danbury's wins against the Black Bears, four of them are after regulation. Three in a shootout, one in overtime, and their one regulation win back on January 19th. Black Bears have won three of the last four games between the two teams. Hat tricks have taken four of the past seven. That after Binghamton had dominated the season series through seven games, winning the first six. All but the first meeting of the year on the 20th of October. That's a long time ago. 3-2 hat trick shootout victory. Connor McCullum, the winning goaltender. But we've got overtime hockey. Hat tricks searching for their seventh win in the last nine games and trying to make it five wins on seven tries during this nine-game homestand. Ruiz, McKittrick, and LaBelle start for the hat tricks. Logar, Smith, and Bond for the Black Bears. And the three-on-three overtime is underway, and there's McKittrick flying up the left side, one-on-one with Bond. McKittrick stops, shoots, save Egbert. And he holds on to the juggling puck. McKittrick trying to sneak it underneath the arm of Egbert, who, in regulation, stopped 31 of 35 hat trick shots. Same three on for Danbury. Ruiz kicking it to himself. Spits to McKittrick. Curling at the right point. Drops for Ruiz. LaBelle did not locate. And the hat trick's forwards need a change. Ratcliffe hops on. Won the shootout last weekend against Port Huron. Had the game winner in round five of that shootout. Connor Smith weaving in, shoots, deflected wide. Bond from the right point. Self-pass, Harwell closes him off. Black Bears making a change. Kirk beyond, three on two for Danbury. LaBelle peels off. Ratcliffe in the fishbowl, wanders middle. Abdella off the bench. Ratcliffe looking for a lane, poke check by Smith. Harwell, two goals tonight. Goals 3 and 4 for the hat tricks in this game gave Danbury a 4-2 lead in the second period. Hat tricks offsides as we've played a minute and 12 seconds in this overtime. Black Bears have 91 points this season. They've played in just 8 games past regulation. They've lost 6 of them. Their 2 wins in a shootout. Mentioned the hat trick numbers off the top. Danbury this season has played in 12 games past regulation. Connor Woolley walks the line, fakes the shot. Drops off for Abdellah. It's Falanga, Woolley, and Abdellah on the ice for the hat-tricks against Yates, Kirkby, and Fitzgerald. Woolley weaving into the zone, drags it back out. Woolley off, Cunningham on. Falanga replaced by Woolley. Cunningham zigzagging over the center ice logo, cuts middle, shoot safe, rebound! Egbert stopped it! Cunningham back on it. Hops over the glove of Ruiz. Here come the Black Bears 2-on-1. Thompson, left side, shoots! Saved by McCollum! And he's got the rebound underneath his glove! Both of these goalies putting on a show in overtime. Cunningham thought he ended it. Had 2 opportunities. Egbert says no. And then McCollum, standing tall at the top of his crease, denies Connor Smith, who is second on the Black Bears in goals. Coming in, it's Yao McKittrick and Harwell. Yao gallops up the left side, crisscrosses through the middle, drops off for Harwell at the right circle, cuts in, shoots, save! Kicked out by Egbert to the far boards. Yao, center point, wrister fought off by Egbert, and he controls the rebound. Harwell took a tumble. Fans don't like it. But the hat-tricks will gladly accept an offensive zone face-off with 2:27 on the clock, overtime, 4-4 the score. Face-off to the right circle. Harwell wins it forward, sweeping it towards the goal, paddled down by Egbert. And the face-off in the exact same spot. Logar and Harwell. Logar out there with Anderson and Smith. Harwell with McKittrick and Yao. Hat-tricks win it. Yao moves in, shoots off the stick of Egbert. McKittrick darts to the middle, has some space. McKittrick waiting, looking, shoots, scores! Daniel McKittrick, overtime winner! He picked his spot, did not miss. 5-4 hat-tricks. Oh, did they need that? 2 points over the Black Bears. They make it 7 wins in the last 9. And Daniel McKittrick with the game winner in overtime. And the trend continues. In every game the hat-tricks have scored 4 or more goals, they have beaten the Black Bears this season. Their 6th win in game number 15 between the two teams. 2 big points for the hat-tricks. It's not 3, but 2 will do. They are now 7 behind the Rockers for 2nd place in the division. Now the play is under review. So hold your horses. You see the goal one more time, maybe goalie interference, but Egbert appeared outside of the blue paint. Now I was watching the NHL on ABC earlier today and there was a very similar situation. They deemed it a good goal because the puck crossed the line, the goalie was outside of the crease. So what is the ruling here tonight? It's either a 5-4 hat-tricks win in overtime or we'll play the remainder of the OT period. Everyone standing, waiting, watching, and hoping that Danbury comes away with a victory. If it is a good goal, it's the 8th for McKittrick, who had just 1 point in his last 4 games coming into tonight. He is the team leader in assists. It would be his first goal of the night for sure. We're still waiting on the ruling. For McKittrick, it would be his second point of the night. Here's the decision. It's a goal! Game over! A special night in Danbury, capped off with a Daniel McKittrick OT winner. Wow! Billy McCreary tossing his hat in celebration. And now the Litchfield Distillery victory barrel, and it's Daniel McKittrick with his second game-winning goal of the season. Number 8 overall, and everyone here in Danbury goes home happy. What a game. Unbelievable. First game of the weekend set. Hattricks will face off with Elmira tomorrow. At 3 o'clock, puck drop. And how did we get here? What a roller coaster of a game. Hattricks led 1-0, 2:16 in, 21 seconds later. Binghamton tied it. They took the lead a little later in the first period. Hattricks rattled off 3 unanswered goals. They led 4-2 in this game. Binghamton with 2 straight of their own to tie it at 13:19 of the third period. And Daniel McKittrick with the overtime winner at 2:47 of the overtime seals the deal. 5-4, game over. Just waiting for the first stars here in Danbury. Players still exiting the ice following an exhilarating and thrilling night of hockey. We've hit 10 o'clock p.m. Eastern time. And the finishing touches on an extraordinary night. 3 stars tonight. They give the third star to Gavin Yates, had a goal and an assist tonight. The second star belonging to the Hattricks. 2 goals and an assist. Chase Harwell. No surprise on the first star tonight. The hero
and tonight's first star
in Danbury
with the game-winning goal, number 22, Daniel McKittrick.
McKittrick with the GWG and GO, baby. Game over, Hattricks 5, Black Bears 4. We're back on the air tomorrow, 3 p.m. puck drop, another Sunday matinee, and I'll be on the call for it if you want to be here. Skate with the Hattricks after the game. If you're a member of the kids club, you get a free ticket. If you're not and you have a child 14 or under, sign them up, get the code, get the ticket. We'd love to see you here. It's also Scouts Night. We had a very successful first round of Scouts Night. Trying it again tonight. We have another one coming up later on in the season, but we'd love to see you. You get a patch if you are signed up and ready to go as part of the Scout Night. That just about does it for us here in Danbury. Hattricks 5, Black Bears 4, shots finish off 41-37, and Daniel McKittrick with the game-winning goal in overtime at 2:47. For everyone helping me out behind the scenes when I had to run down and help out with the first intermission Ring of Honor ceremony, we thank them. I thank you for watching. I'm Doug Latuca saying have a great rest of your night, Hattricks fans. We'll talk again. 3